There's a wide shot of the Frankie Vincennes, our director, alertly gives us a wide shot to tie in with our dialogue about the house here, and you can see they're jam-packed. Okay, as you check your screen there, folks, you'll take a good long look. You'll notice that we're eagerly awaiting the event. Probably everybody's been waiting for it for a while. Larry Zbysko, Ivan Putski, here comes Zbysko.
Here they come.
Now.
Well, as you know, Dick, psychology is my business, and I will tell you, Larry Zbysko is a nasty man.
Yes.
He is a clinical example of psychopathology.
Very good, Professor. I like that. There, you got some signs on there. What is it, something?
Zbysko is the new living legend. He does have his fans.
All right. Here comes Ivan Putski. Oh, look out, look out, look out. We're underway, fans, ready or not. Gary Capetta, the ring announcer, has got out fast, and it's underway now.
Well, this is a Texas death match.
We barely had time to tell you that this is the return of the Texas death match. And I tell you, anything goes tonight, fans.
Heavy on his ear, heavy. He's grinding into his ear.
I'll tell you.
Oh, he's in his throat.
Well, you know, no, there are no rules tonight.
No rules.
Old fire, Cal. So, fans, you're watching World War III tonight.
He has totally cut off his wind.
Yeah. I'll tell you.
All right.
The only thing is, the third man in the ring, Dick Worley, only asked, have you submitted? That's all he said. Outside of that, anything goes. Boy, they're loving it tonight. Listen to the fans react to that. Woo!
The crowd is going crazy.
Well,
I got in the ring.
Uh-oh.
Going to hit him on the railing.
He's got him down there now.
He's totally cut off his wind, Dick.
Whoa, look at that.
Zbysko's just hanging on.
You ever see a guy look at Putski? Totally serious.
And totally in command.
Oh, yeah.
Zbysko's running for cover for us. Here he comes. He says, I'll bust his head. He said he's going to kill him. He took the right corner on him. He's going to kill him. He's choking him to death.
He's got him now.
Yeah, with that microphone cord. He's totally cut off his wind. Zbysko's out. His eyeballs are up into his forehead.
Okay, the right's back in front of it, fans. Zbysko's going to run for the ring to get out of the way of Zbysko. Because he wasn't doing too well against Zbysko outside the ring. I'm telling you, it's crazy.
Oh, Zbysko's begging for mercy. He has no wind at all. There was a cry of anguish.
I heard it.
His eyeballs are up in his forehead. There is no life in his eyes.
The fans here, ringside, and
he's crying. He's crying. He's begging for mercy. He can't breathe.
But there are no rules tonight, Cal.
There are no rules. He can kill him if he wants to.
That's right. And very well might. Oh, fans, I've never seen anything like this.
Not the way out of the ring. Calvin Payne is screaming. Zbyszko screaming and pouring. Oh, he's begging.
He's trying to
you to stop it. Yeah.
He's trying to protect his lower extremities.
Well, he's screaming. You want me to stop it? Zbyszko's in agony. He's going to break his leg. Oh, he's twisting. He's saying no.
I give Zbyszko credit. He looks like he's being killed, but he won't.
Yeah. Uh-oh. Landed right on his knee on the concrete.
Here comes Putski on Zbyszko again.
He's going to break the chair on his head. He was terrified that he was going to break that chair over his head.
There was this guy, he's a terrified, look at him.
Yeah, there's terror in his eyes, Dick, terror. He's in another world, Dick.
Oh!
Oh, he did it. He did it.
Maybe that wasn't terror at all.
That was desperation, Dick. That's the only move he could have made.
To heaven, don't you can hear it, okay. But you gotta be here.
Yeah, what a recovery.
The
Zbyszko's
fans are going crazy.
Well, the padding's off and he's using it.
Zbyszko just wobbling, trying to get around the ring. Putski's covering himself in the lower part of his body, knowing that Zbyszko might very well go there again.
Yep. Ivan has to take this beating. He knows it, but he's going to recover.
Look at the determination on Putski's face.
Yeah. Oh, that hurt. Right up against the metal. He looks like Popeye the Sailorman after a can of spinach.
Look at Putski. Look at the beating he's taking.
Putting his muscles together. Oh!
He's
in his face.
He did it.
When you dish it out, you got to be prepared to take it. Oh, the
I think Zbyszko's voice going to hit C above high C.
Yes. Well, his voice is hitting notes never hit by man before.
Never hit before. Only dogs will be able to hear him.
Yeah, only dogs.
Oh, he is in sheer agony. Look at him.
Yeah.
And Putski out after him.
He's after him.
Down on the table again.
Putski's got murder in his eye.
He really does, man.
He's going to hit him against the post.
I'll tell you.
Oh, he's choking him. He's got his wind totally cut off with the canvas.
I'll tell you, Putski's just driving him. Driving his head to outer space. Look at it. All the action right outside the ring now, man.
There's a murderous
I'll remind you again, the Texas Death Match, there are no rules. Although one of the assistant commissioners...
Oh, he's got his wind cut off, totally. Look, all his weight is on his throat, all of his weight.
Look at that shot, fans. Look at that shot. Beautiful. Great shot.
Yeah, he smacked him right on the table. Zbyszko has no wind whatsoever. He's gasping for breath, gasping. He's grabbing the canvas, trying to pull himself up.
All right, Larry Zbyszko is down. But Dick Rowley leading outside. Look at this guy.
Here comes a replay on the kick.
All right. Here we're going to watch it out, fans. We'll take you back a few seconds as Zbyszko is literally pulling Ivan Putski. But there he got a kick again, and that's where it all started.
So let's go back and ring, as you can see, and Pupsky take him out there.
Zbyszko is living in agony in this match. He's ruining his back foot. The crowd is chanting with Pupsky.
I don't know how much more this man can take. Let me remind you again, there are no rules here. Anything goes. And who's gonna stop it? It can only be stopped for a pin, or it can be stopped if somebody submits. Zbyszko has enough to rake his fingers across the ring. Pupsky, he retaliates. Look out, fans, you'll see it tonight.
He's in total agony, Dick.
Yep.
That is an excruciating bear hug right in a rib cage.
There were no rules tonight. The fact that Zbyszko's feet were up on the side of the ring post and the ropes has no bearing on this at all. It was a pin. And funny, I didn't expect it. I just said it could either end as a pin or somebody submits. I didn't realize what happened.
Well, Zbyszko got the beating of his life, Dick.
He certainly did tonight. Wow.
You were pretty cool under fire.
I tried to be.
Right, Dick.
I'm getting used to it now. All right, let's check your screen, fans, wherever you are watching, because here is Zbyszko trying desperately to get out. He manages to fall down, but now we're approaching the pin. Now watch as it happens. This is slow-mo, slow motion. Pupsky comes over. Here, the legs go out from under him. Zbyszko, maybe we don't pick it up, but Zbyszko's feet, I believe, were up on the ropes, got an extra leverage. Pupsky was trying everything, grabbing the hair, trying to push the head aside to break it. Look at him, look at him. Yeah. He doesn't believe it. And I don't either.
Yeah, he got caught in that corner.
Well, I'll tell you, those who say that Zbyszko for president, some of the signs around here were saying that. And, of course, he himself says he's the new living legend. I don't know. Well, I'll tell you, Cal, like it or not, you fans listening may not like what I have to say, but Zbyszko took a cruel beating tonight and came back.
Yeah, that was the beating of his life, other than the ones he took from Bruno Sammartino.
Cal, he came back. Well, I mean, you've got to admire the guy. I mean, I expect somebody to shoot him with a shotgun to put him away. I thought that was the only way Pupsky would really do him in, but I can't believe Zbyszko really showed me something. I don't like his tactics, but he showed me something tonight.
Yeah, he's a man and a half, no question about it.
Tell you.
No wonder he didn't say hello to anybody. He knew the beating he was going to take.
Well, he knew he was in trouble tonight, and he really is.